private sector banks have been allowed and district central cooperative banks have been kept out. Why? I know several district central cooperative banks in Maharashtra which are fine banks with a fine record. For example, the Pune District Central Cooperative Bank has a capital adequacy ratio of over 13%. It has got zero NPA. 97% of its account holders have KYC, know your customer. Yet the bank has been kept out. Government's answer is district central cooperative banks are mismanaged. Then I ask, why are urban central cooperative banks allowed? What is the difference between a district central cooperative bank and an urban central cooperative bank? If urban banks are so well managed, how is it in Jaipur yesterday the Integral Urban Cooperative Bank was found to be laundering money? Keeping out district central cooperative bank is a way of punishing the farmers of this country. Each bank has got 200-250 branches. These branches are essentially in the villages. In those villages, there is no other bank. That is the only bank in the village. People put their money, take their money out of that bank. And by this, the farmers of this country have been punished. Today, there is no money to buy seeds, no money to buy fertilizer, no money to hire labor. In every major town, there is a naka or a chowk where daily workers gather in the morning and somebody will come and pick up 10 workers, 50 workers. In Delhi, it is known as a chori chowk, I think. In Mumbai, it is in Bangup, I think. It is called
Chowdi Bai. Chowdi Bai.
Every town, small town, big town. There's no work. Headload workers, cart pullers, daily workers, there is no work. 45 crore people in this country depend on daily income. 45 crore people in this country depend on earning a daily income. If that income is not coming to me today, tomorrow nobody is going to compensate for that. If I lose my income today, I lose it forever. 45 crore people. Out of that, 15 crore people depend upon a wage income. They have to work for somebody. The remaining 30 crore are flower sellers, fruit sellers, vegetable sellers, milk vendors, dhobi, milkman, barber, cobbler, carpenter, plumber, electrician, who do a daily job. 45 crore.
Last 30 odd days. Now who's going to compensate them? They have lost their income, they have lost their wages, they have cut back on food, they have cut back on medicine. Many of them are migrant workers. Since they have no work, they are going back to their villages. Who's going to compensate them? This is a completely thoughtless move. Nobody in the world has a good word to say about it. Every major economist has condemned it. Every major newspaper in the world has said this is a completely absurd move of the government. This pain will continue. Already it is documented, 91 people have died standing in queues or because they've committed suicide, because they have no money. Now who is going to compensate those families? I think the situation is being made worse by thoughtless pronouncements. Yesterday, a leading RSS spokesman has said the 2000 rupee note also should be withdrawn. I won't be surprised if they do that. In fact, the whole game may have been to lure people to keeping 2000 rupee note and then declaring 2000 rupee also as illegal. Ultimately, it is the poor people in this country who are punished. On 8th November, Prime Minister said the word black money 18 times. On 27th November, he made two speeches.
In the two speeches, he mentioned black money 9 times and he mentioned cashless economy 24 times. So no longer it is the old objective of black money, counterfeit currency or terrorist funding. Now it is a new goal. The goalpost is shifting. Suddenly they've discovered cashless economy. I ask, which country in the world has got a cashless economy? Which country? America has got a cashless economy? Singapore has got a cashless economy? World over, small value transactions are always done by cash. If I go and buy popcorn or chole bhatura, I don't pay by card. High value transactions can be done by card. And the Prime Minister suddenly says the whole country must become cashless. The Finance Minister says the whole country will become cashless. How will it become cashless? Where are the POS machines? Where is electricity? Where is Wi-Fi connection? In the villages, there is a village weekly market. I don't know the practice in Maharashtra.
Yeah.
Village weekly market. In village A, it will be Monday. Village B will be Tuesday. Village C will be Wednesday. That is how the market is. In that market, people bring their vegetable, fruit, jaggery, cucumber, baskets, toys, and they sell and buy. That village markets have all been closed for the last 30 days. All the major mandis are closed. Cotton market in Gujarat is closed. Azadpur is closed. Hapur is closed. Footwear market in Agra is closed. Brassware market in Moradabad is closed. Sports goods is closed. Every major market is closed. And then the government says we will move to a digital economy. How will you move to a digital economy? This is the worst attack on the poor of this country. I ask you, I went to a wedding a few days ago, a wealthy family's wedding. None of the rich people seem to be concerned. There is no concern on their faces. It is the poor who are affected. And ultimately, I want to ask, 15,44,000 crore is the value of the notes that have been impounded. Suppose all of this comes back to the banking system. What is this exercise for? Already I'm told 13 lakh crore has come back. In fact, yesterday the RSS spokesperson in a speech said over 13 lakh crore has come back. We still have another 16-17 days to go. If the entire 15 lakh crore comes back to the banking system, what have you done this for? There is a Hindi proverb. Sorry for my pronunciation. Koda pahad nikli chuhiya. Why have you done this exercise? I think the people of this country must be sensitized to the fact that this is an assault on the poor. This has broken the back of 45 crore people who depend on a daily wage and a daily income. The completely thoughtless, meaningless move by the government, and ultimately it may yield no results whatsoever.